in between valence band and conduction band, there is a gap. This gap is called forbidden gap. Forbidden gap, it is gap between conduction band and valence band. The bottom of conduction band, which has energy level equal to EC, and top of valence band, which has energy level equal to EV, difference between these two is called energy gap. So, EG is given as EC minus EV, that is lowest conduction band energy minus highest valence band energy. Now, let us see distinction, that is how can we differentiate between conductors, that are metals, insulators and semiconductors based on band theory. First, we talk of metals. So, metals have partially filled conduction band and fully filled valence band. So, valence band is completely filled and conduction band is partially filled. The energy gap between them is absent. Normally, the conduction band overlaps with the valence band, such that the Fermi level in the valence band, it lies inside the conduction band. What is Fermi level? We will discuss a little later. So, due to this overlapping, the electrons of valence band are available in conduction band are free to move. Therefore, metals are good conductors of electricity. Now, coming to Fermi level, what is Fermi level? So, Fermi energy level, it is topmost layer of valence band with filled electrons and at 0 Kelvin. So, this level is called Fermi level. It should be noted that at 0 Kelvin, all levels up to Fermi level are completely filled with electrons, and above Fermi level, all the levels are empty. In case of metals, the topmost layer of valence band is Fermi energy level, but however, in case of insulators or semiconductors, this level can be different, though it will lie in the valence band only. For example, if this is our valence band and our electrons are filled up to this level only, then this level will be said to be Fermi energy level. So, this is topmost level with filled electron at 0 Kelvin. When temperature is increased at temperature greater than 0 Kelvin, due to thermal agitations, electrons may get excited and they jump to energy levels above Fermi energy level. In case of metals, the Fermi energy level is already in conduction band, so electrons are available freely to move to conduct electricity. Now, coming to insulators. In case of insulators, the valence band is completely filled with electrons, whereas conduction band is empty. The energy gap between the topmost of valence band and lowermost level of conduction band is more than 3 electron volt. Even with a strong electric field, it is not possible for electrons to excite from valence band to conduction band. Electrons are bounded to their atoms inside valence band only. Therefore, insulators cannot conduct because of lack of free electrons. Coming to semiconductors. In case of semiconductors, at 0 Kelvin, valence band is filled while conduction band is empty, and they behave essentially as insulators. However, energy gap between them is less than 3 electron volt. For example, in case of silicon, it is 1.17 electron volt, and for germanium, it is 0.74 electron volt. When temperature is increased, the electron hole pairs are created. And since this energy gap is quite low, these electrons may jump from valence band to conduction band, and they are free to move in conduction band, while the holes that are created in valence band, they are also free to move. Therefore, at room temperature or at higher temperatures, semiconductors can conduct electricity due to movement of electrons in conduction band and movement of holes in valence band. It should be noted that the number of electrons that jump from valence band to conduction band is given by this formula. N is equal to C into e to the power minus Eg, stands for energy gap, divided by 2 times Kb, Kb is Boltzmann constant, and T, T stands for absolute temperature. Therefore, the resistance in case of semiconductors is not as large as it is in case of insulators, and they acquire some conductivity even at room temperature. On increasing temperature, the conductivity is further increased. Now, let us talk of energy band of intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductors. First, intrinsic semiconductor. At 0 Kelvin, the valence band is completely filled, whereas conduction band is empty. Now, when temperature is increased, some of the electrons from valence band jump to conduction band and they are free to move. Holes are created in valence band and holes can also move. Therefore, these intrinsic semiconductors can conduct electricity at room temperature or at higher temperatures. Now, let us discuss extrinsic semiconductors. First, N type of extrinsic semiconductor. In this case, we have this EC. EC is energy level corresponding to lowest energy in conduction band. EV is energy level corresponding to highest energy level in valence band. And there is another line, red line, this is ED. ED is energy associated with the donor electron of the pentavalent impurity donor atom that we add to form or to obtain an N-type extrinsic semiconductor. Now, this will be noted that the electron that which is unbounded in case of an N-type extrinsic semiconductor, that electron has an, so that electron can be shown to be here on this line, on ED line. So, its energy is very slightly, it is slightly lesser than energy level of EC. It is of the order of 0.01 electron volt. So, EC minus ED is of the order of 0.01 electron volt. At room temperature, these electrons, they can easily jump from ED level to conduction band and thereby increasing number of electrons in the conduction band. Further, at room temperature and above that temperature, due to formation of electron hole pairs, there are more electrons here which are available due to breaking of silicon-silicon covalent bond. So, from valence band, we have electrons in conduction band and holes are created in valence band. Now, due to excess of electrons, the majority charge carriers in N-type of extrinsic semiconductors are electrons. Now, coming to P-type extrinsic semiconductor. In P-type extrinsic semiconductor, we have this energy level, this is called acceptor energy level. Now, this energy difference is like 0.01 electron volt to 0.05 electron volt. So, it is very easier for electrons in valence band to jump from valence band to acceptor energy level, so as to complete the octet of the acceptor atom and thereby creating many holes in the valence band. Now, these holes, they can conduct in valence band. So, in case of a p-type extrinsic semiconductor, the majority charge carriers are holes, while minority charge carriers are electrons. These electrons is made available due to breaking of silicon-silicon covalent bond at higher temperatures, and they again create holes here. So, holes are in majority. Let us discuss mobility of charge carriers. We have already seen mobility in chapter electricity previously. So, electrical mobility is defined as drift velocity of charge carrier per unit electric field. It is denoted by nu. This nu is equal to Vd. This is drift velocity of charge carrier, it may be an electron, it may be a hole, divided by electric field. So, Vd drift velocity is given as nu times E. We should note that mobility of electron is always greater in conduction band than that of holes in valence band. And why is it so? It is because conduction band is relatively free. There is more space in it, whereas in valence band it has got a rich density of electrons. So, because of larger free space in conduction band, the mobility of electrons in conduction band is always greater. Now, let us try to derive an expression for electrical conductivity sigma of a semiconductor. Now, total current, as we have discussed, is given as sum of electronic current and hole current. And we have derived this formula that current is given as A into N into E into Vd. So, electronic current will be given as A into number density of electrons into charge on electron into drift velocity of electron plus IH is given as A into number density of holes into charge on hole, that is plus E into drift velocity of hole. When we take A E common, we have I is equal to A E into N E V E plus N H V H. Now, I is given as V upon R from Ohm's law, we have seen it. R can further be written as rho into L by A, this A will go in the numerator and this A will cancel with this A. So, we have 1 upon rho into V upon L is equal to capital E into small e into in bracket it is N E into mu E plus N H into nu H. We know V is equal to E into L, because when we apply potential difference across the semiconductor, electric field is generated. Electrons start to move opposite to electric field and holes start to move along the electric field. If the length of this semiconductor is L, we can have this expression V is equal to E into L. So, V upon L can be written as E, and this E will cancel with this E. So, we have 1 upon rho, and reciprocal of resistivity is conductivity sigma. Sigma is equal to E, magnitude of the charge on an electron, into number density of electron into mobility of electron plus number density of holes into mobility of holes. So, this is expression for electrical conductivity in case of a semiconductor. Now coming to photoconductivity, we know that the light radiations are comprised of photons, and photons have energy h into nu. Now whenever a photon or light radiation with energy h nu, that is greater than energy gap, falls on intrinsic semiconductor, it will create electron hole pair. And when electron hole pairs are created, the conductivity of the semiconductor is increased. So this process is called photoconductivity.